I heard that our pianist this evening is going to speak before the other two pieces, so I was jealous, so I decided, oh, there we go. I wanted to say a few words of introduction. It's hard to know where to begin to introduce my three friends and colleagues this evening. Growing up in this family, and I can say this family of these three people because they knew Seymour long before they knew me, has been more than an adventure, and I think having music be such a part of the fabric of everything we did was very, very meaningful. I learned a lot more about life than I ever learned about music through them, especially watching the three of them collaborate. I've seen them go through lots of fights and lots of fun times and mostly hysterical laughing. We had to set twice as many rehearsals as we needed because we laughed for at least 50% of every rehearsal. And as my father always told me, it doesn't matter how the concert goes, it's the rehearsals that count. So, with that in mind, here we go.
We had to put in a trio because Marin has to study her scores for the rehearsal tomorrow. Now, the Ravel trio, the only trio that Ravel wrote for this combination of instruments, is one of his greatest and most serious works. He began composing it in 1914, and the First World War broke out, and he was moved by a spirit of patriotism, and he wanted to enlist in the army. But he had an aged mother, and she was very ill, and he was afraid that the shock would kill her. And so he was torn between patriotism and devotion for his mother, and he fell into a deep state of depression. And he wrote to a friend during the composing of the work, and he said to his friend, "I find myself sobbing over the flats and sharps." He completed the work in that same year. The scherzo movement is lively, and the first movement is serene, and one can only marvel at the quality of the music considering how depressed Ravel was. The second movement, as you see, is marked pantoum, and this is the only time that that word appears in music. A pantoum actually is a poetic verse used by Baudelaire and said to be of Malay origin, and it's a technique whereby the second and the fourth lines of the first stanza become the first and the third lines of the next stanza, although we can't figure out what connection that has to the music. But Ravel did feel something of the pantoum in writing this. The Passacaglia is very morbid, very dark, and it starts in the bass register of the piano, and the Passacaglia theme is then shared by the other instruments alternately, and the last movement ends exuberantly. Now, Ravel thought that the combination of piano, violin, and cello was actually incompatible, and he set out to resolve these problems because, you know, pianists are always so noisy. Now, he created what everyone seems to think is the greatest trio for this particular set of instruments, but there is one criticism leveled at the trio, and that is that it's just too plain difficult.
Thank you. Thank you.